All you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Hands of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the Mission Sunday, the 30th Sunday in ordinary time. We are reminded of our special vocation to bear witness to Christ through our life and through everything that we have. We pray for the mission of the church. And as we recognize our responsibility, let us also ask the Lord, forgive us for the times we have failed to fulfill our vocation to bear testimony to the Lord. To celebrate this Eucharist worthily, therefore, let us ask the Lord forgiveness for all our sins and failures. I confess to Almighty God
and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, to my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy on us all. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy on us all. Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy on us all.
Glory be to the Father. Glory be to the Son. Glory be to the Spirit. All glory to our God. We praise you, we bless you, we give you thanks. We praise you for your glory. We praise you, we bless you, we worship you. Oh Lord our God, glory be to the Father, glory be to the Son, glory be to the Spirit, all glory to our God. Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Son of God, you are one with the Father. Receive our prayer. Glory be to the Father. Glory be to the Son. Glory be to the Spirit. All glory to our God. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God. Glory be to the Father. Glory be to the Son. Glory be to the Spirit. All glory to our God.
Let us pray. O God, whose will it is that all should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth, look upon your abundant harvest and be pleased to send workers to gather it, that the gospel may be preached to all creation, and that your people, gathered by the word of life and sustained by the power of the sacraments, may advance in the path of salvation and love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 2, verses 1 to 5. The word that Isaiah, the son of Amoz, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. It shall come to pass in the later days that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be lifted up above all the hills, and all the nation shall flow to it, and many people shall come and say, come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and shall decide disputes for many peoples, and they shall beat their sword into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my bonds, beyond my fears, from death into my spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my bonds, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 10, verses 9 to 18. Brethren, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes and is justified, and with the mouth one confess and is saved. For the scripture says, everyone who believes in him will not be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. For the same Lord is Lord of all, bestowing his riches on all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. How then will you, they call on him is whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe in him of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone preaching? And how are they to preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the good news. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Israel says, Lord, who has believed what he has heard from us? So faith comes from hearing, and hearing comes through the word of Christ. But I ask, have they not heard? Indeed, they have. For their voice has gone out of all the earth, and their words of the ends of the world. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christian people, open your ears and hear good news. Open your hearts, O royal priesthood.
God has come to you.
God has spoken to His people. Alleluia. And His words are words of wisdom. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, appearing to the 11, Jesus said to them, "Go into all the world and proclaim the gospel to the whole creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. But whoever does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name they will cast out demons. They will speak in new tongues. They will pick up serpents with their hands. And if they drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt them. They will lay their hands on the sick and they will recover." So then the Lord Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into heaven and sat down at the right hand of God. And they went out and preached everywhere while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the message by accompanying signs. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to our Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today as we celebrate the Mission Sunday, we are given these passages from Isaiah, from the letter of Paul to Romans, and from the Gospel of Mark. Jesus went up to the mountains to pray, to be with the Father. And people went up to the mountain to pray, to be in communion with the Father. Mountain also as a place away from the community, away from the hurry-burries of life, to be with God. Today too, the Lord is inviting us to be with Him, to leave the worldly affairs and be in His presence so that He can communicate to us. Before the Lord went up into heaven, He gathered the disciples on the mountain, and it is there that He gave them the instruction. The final instruction: go into the whole world and preach the good news, giving them authority over everything, all authority in heaven and earth. And this authority is to be used in order to bring salvation to all humanity. God wants to save everyone. And yet, there is this freedom that is granted to every human person, that they may believe, those who believe in their hearts. Paul tells us very clearly, those who believe in their hearts that Jesus is Lord, they will be saved. And those who proclaim with their lips that He is Lord, as the opportunity comes to them, what they believe, they must proclaim. Primarily, therefore, all those who believe in the Lord will be saved. This faith that is inside us will be put to test from time to time whether we are able to live this faith. Many people, they believe and yet are afraid of living it in their daily life. Perhaps out of fear, out of being recognized by other people, because there are large number of people who do not believe or who mock at religion and faith. So there is this tendency to hide one's faith and pretend as if I do not belong to this group. The Lord says, when you have an opportunity, you must bear testimony. And that will be an opportunity also for others to be saved, so that they too may hear the word. They may also have the touch of the power of God, the word of God and the power of God, the Holy Spirit. All those who are to be saved, whom the Lord has counted, would definitely open their hearts and their ears to the word that is spoken to them. And here comes the importance of the World Mission Sunday, when we recall that all of us, when we received baptism, we proclaimed, either directly or through our godparents and parents, that we renounce Satan and everything that belongs to him, and that we believe in God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and in the church, in the communion of the saints, in the forgiveness of sins, and in everlasting life. We proclaimed that we believe that Jesus is the Son of God who has come to save us. And by believing in him, we have forgiveness for our sins, because we are all sinners, every one of us. And so the good news is this, that the Lord has come to save us. He has paid the price for us. And so this must be proclaimed. Paul tells us today in the letter to the Romans, how can people believe unless there is someone to proclaim this good news? And this is our responsibility. It is not enough that we believe in our hearts, but we must also testify to the Lord, proclaim this good news in our daily life. This is a serious responsibility. It is because of this proclamation, because of testifying to the Lord, many had the opportunity of becoming martyrs from the early church onwards. And it continues throughout the century, throughout history, even in our own time. There are innumerable people, countless people, testifying to the faith that they have. There are several thousands being martyred just because they believe in Christ. But this persecution or martyrdom has not put an end to the good news. The good news is being proclaimed. If one village or one nation is eradicated from the believers, there would be others growing up, sprouting like the grass from the blood of the martyrs. And so the believer, the Christian, should not be afraid of proclaiming the good news. The good news basically is that God loves you, whoever you are, whatever your situation is, how sinful you may be, yet God loves you because he has created you for himself, and he wants to save you. Because you cannot save yourself, he sent his Son, and he was born of this woman, Mary of Nazareth, whom God had chosen even before the foundation of the world. And through her, the Savior is born in a human manner, in a human nature like ours. He took our nature, and in this human nature, God suffered and atoned for our sins. And not that He just died on the cross, but He rose from the dead, thus renewing humanity, renewing human nature into the image of God, the risen Lord. And so it is in Him that we have life. We are born in the flesh, but we are given this opportunity to be born in spirit. As Jesus tells Nicodemus, unless you are born again from above, you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. This good news has to be preached to all peoples all over the world. And even today, as we celebrate this Eucharist and this Mission Sunday, it is our responsibility to be united with the Church in this mission of proclaiming the good news of salvation for all humanity. Various modes are used, all available methods are used to convey and communicate this good news to all people, so that no one should say that I did not know, I was not told of this good news. Even in our own times, there are many people who say, oh, I never knew that this is the good news. Because many people consider Christianity and Christians as something else. So this good news has to reach to all people, that salvation comes by believing in Jesus Christ, who has paid the price for our sins. By believing, you accept Him as Savior and Lord. And when you accept Him, then you are receiving this salvation, or the salvation is in you, because divine life begins in you, in Jesus Christ. And this good news is, it is so simple for all people to be saved. It is enough that they believe in their hearts. Once you begin to believe in your heart that God has saved me, that my life is united with Jesus, my life begins to be a new life, a life in Jesus. And that life in Jesus is new life that we live as Christians, testifying to the presence of God in our lives. And so renouncing sin, renouncing worldliness, a life lived spiritually in this world, already foreshadowing the eternal life. This is the responsibility of all Christians, all of us. We have this responsibility to bear testimony to the Lord, so that our life may become a proclamation. We ourselves may not be able to reach to the ends of the world to proclaim, even though now perhaps it is possible through the media that is available, that we may be able to reach to the ends of the world, people living everywhere, but in different languages, possibility of translating into all the languages and reaching it out. And yet, there are in every nation, in every place, there are people working together. There are missionaries who have dedicated their life entirely for the proclamation of the gospel. We must support them first through our prayers, that we support them that their mission may succeed, that they may fight the good fight against the powers of darkness and evil. Through our prayer support, we must reach out to all missions, just like Saint Teresa of Child Jesus, who reached out to the missions and missionaries and to all people from the cell where she lived through her prayers and sacrifices. And the second is reaching out with all the resources that we have, whatever we have, to share part of it for the good of the Church, for the mission of the Church, so that those who have dedicated themselves to the missions, they may be supported, they may not want anything, they may not lack anything in their mission, in reaching out the good news to other people. Communication also, we know, is expensive. Everything is expensive. And that is where our responsibility to reach help to the missions. When we celebrate Mission Sunday, definitely there is a collection being made. We hand over part of our contribution, our income, what we have sweated and made out, something we give for the mission of the church, which will be used precisely for this purpose of supporting the missionaries, supporting the missions all over the world, wherever it is needed in an urgent manner. And so let us be generous, first through our prayers and through the contributions that we make, so that those who have dedicated their lives can be supported by the church, and the mission of the church may continue forward in our time to the future generations. And so let us pray that God's blessings may come on us and all those who cooperate with the mission of the church, that we ourselves may receive God's blessings. The fruit of the work of missions may come to us. A share of it will definitely come to us when we join with the prayer and also support through whatever means are available to us. May God bless the missions, the missionaries, and all of us who are part of this mission of the church. Let us stand for the creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again.
From the dead he ascended into heaven.
And is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty.
From there he will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
Go into all the world and proclaim the gospel to the whole creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, that with the assistance of the Holy Spirit, we too may contribute towards the further advancement of the work of evangelization. We pray, saying, Lord, make us your zealous missionaries.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that they may courageously preach the gospel to one and all, especially through the means of social communication, we pray.
Lord, make us zealous missionaries.
For vocations to priestly and religious life, that the pastoral care of the people of God may go on unhindered, we pray.
Lord, make us your zealous missionaries.
For people who contribute generously, both in terms of material resources and time, for the day-to-day running of their own parishes, that they may be blessed by the Lord, we pray.
Lord, make us your zealous missionaries.
For the European continent that took the message of Christ far and wide through their zealous missionaries, that the faith of the people may grow and flourish, we pray.
Lord, make us your zealous missionaries.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that encouraged by the words of Lord Jesus, we may go forth and bear witness to our Christian faith with courage and zeal, we pray.
Lord, make us your zealous missionaries.
We pray for our church that is moving in the synodal way, taking along every member in its journey, that the church in our time may discern the plan and purpose that God has for us, and that the Holy Spirit may guide those who are entrusted with the responsibility for the church. For this we pray.
Lord, make us your zealous missionaries.
Let us place our own personal intentions before the Lord. God our Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son Jesus, who chose us to be his missionaries. Grant us the grace that we may faithfully fulfill the missionary command of Jesus, our Savior and Lord. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Do your work, and Jesus, Lord, I give them willingly. I give my feet to go your way, and every step I shall take cheerfully. Oh, the joy of the Lord is my strength, my strength. Oh, the joy of the Lord is my help, my help. For the power of His Spirit is in my heart, and the joy of the Lord is my strength. I give my eyes to see the world, and everyone is just the way you do. I give my tongue to speak your words, to spread your name and freedom giving to. Oh, the joy of the Lord is my strength, my strength. Oh, the joy of the Lord is my help, my help. For the power of His Spirit is in my heart, and the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look, O Lord, upon the face of your Christ, who handed Himself over as a ransom for all, so that through Him, from the rising of the sun to its setting, your name may be exalted among the nations, and in every place a single offering may be presented to your majesty, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, He humbled Himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, He freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, He gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. All the earth and heaven sing to God on high. Holy, 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 holy is the Lord. All the earth and heaven sing to God on high. Hosanna, 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 hosanna. In the name of the Lord, blessed is the one who comes from God on high. Blessed
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the one who comes from God on high.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna to the Lord.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna to the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts you have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Franco and Dagnall, our bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. to our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The waters of my soul longs after you. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship you. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You desire, and I long to worship you.
silver only you can satisfy. You alone are the real joy giver and the apple of my eye. Desire and I long to worship you. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire and I long to worship you.
Of Christ, sanctify me.
Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me.
Water from the side of Christ, wash me.
Passion of Christ, strengthen me.
O good Jesus, hear me.
Within thy wounds, hide me.
Suffer me not to be separated from thee.
From the malicious enemy, defend me.
In the hour of my death, call me,
and it may come unto thee.
That with thy saints I may praise thee forever and ever. Amen.
Pray to Saint Michael the Archangel.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
defend us in battle.
Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him.
We humbly pray,
and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host,
by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan
and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world,
seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Prayer for vocations. Lord Jesus, Shepherd of souls, we thank and praise you for the gift of the Catholic Church in a very special way. We place our Catholic youth in your hands. Fill them with the desire of becoming your dedicated priests and nuns. Bless all the parents to be role models for their children through their prayerful living. May these youngsters be ever eager to proclaim your goodness to the nations as you commanded us to do. We make this prayer in your mighty name. Amen.
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let's go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary,
that never was it known that anyone who fled your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful, O Mother of the Word Incarnate.
Despise not my petitions,
but in your mercy,
hear and answer me.
Amen.
Mary, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Pray for the Golden Jubilee Year of the Diocese of Jalandhar. God, our Creator and Father,
we bow our heads before you,
we adore you, and we praise you.
As we celebrate the Golden Jubilee of our Diocese,
we thank you for all the blessings
you have bestowed on us
in the past 49 years.
We join Mother Mary, our patroness,
and make our own heart joyful acclamation.
The Almighty has done great things for us.
We thank you, Lord, for our first shepherd,
Bishop Symphorian,
and all others who have been shepherding our diocese till today.
We thank you for all our past and present missionaries,
priests, sisters, catechists, and lay faithful,
all united in the holy task of announcing the good news of your great love.
Jesus, our Lord and Shepherd, you gave us the command, love one another as I have loved you. With our human limitations, we are more often divided by hatred than united in love. Jesus, we ask you to show us the way in all the choices we make. You have given us St. Francis of Assisi as our model and companion. With him we pray, Lord, make us channels of your peace. Holy Spirit, source of love, joy and peace, come into our hearts and dwell in us, in our families and parishes. Comforting Spirit, come to the side of all who are victims of violence and fear at this moment. Uniting Spirit, heal the wounds of division and discord, and sow seeds of forgiveness and goodwill in every heart. Lead our diocese to renewal in faith, hope and charity.
Mary, Queen of Peace, we entrust our diocese to your loving care.
Your Son has taught us that we minister to him when we serve the homeless, the poor and the needy. Make of us good Samaritans, ready to serve the least of our brothers and sisters, without expecting any reward. May all that we do bring glory and honor to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Mother Mary, intercede for us, that every one of us may pray with sincere hearts the prayer Jesus himself has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Let there be glory and honor and praises, glory and honor to Mary, glory, honor, glory and honor to her. She's the star of the ocean, she's the lighthouse along the way. She's a comfort to those in darkness, she's a beacon for the one who strays. Let there be glory and joy.